We all know that the wonders of life are always there for us. The full moon, the blue sky, the beautiful mountains, the rivers, the beautiful faces of children, they belong to the kingdom of God. And if you are not there, available in the present moment, we miss the kingdom of God. We need only to breathe in and out mindfully, to be fully present in the here and the now in order to get in touch with the kingdom of God. To me, the kingdom of God is always available in the here and the now. The question is whether we are available to the kingdom. In Buddhism, we speak of the pure land of the Buddha. And we know that the pure land of the Buddha is in our heart. If we have the energy of mindfulness and concentration that help us to be there in the here and the now, and then the pure land of the Buddha is available right here and right now. To be home to the present moment, we have the opportunity to be aware of our body, and the practice of mindful breathing, mindful walking can bring peace and harmony into our body and into our feelings, and help us to release the tension in our body and in our feelings. The exercise of breathing in, I'm aware of my body. Breathing out, I release the tension in my body. Everyone can practice. You don't need to be a Buddhist in order to practice that. You sit in whatever position you feel comfortable, and you practice releasing the tension, the pressure in your body. And 1 minute or 2 minutes of practice can make a big difference already. Breathing in, I'm aware of my body. When I breathe in, I generate the energy of mindfulness. And with that energy of mindfulness, I recognize my body as being there. And to continue, if I continue the practice of generating the energy of mindfulness, I go use that energy in order to embrace my body tenderly, and I can help my body to release the tension in it. Because we might have accumulated a lot of tension, a lot of pressure within our body. We might have worked our body too hard. It's time to go home to our body and reconcile with it and help it to release the tension in it. This is possible in the sitting position, in the lying position, in whatever position you might find yourself in, including the standing position and the walking position. The practice of walking mindfully is also possible for every one of us. I always practice mindful walking at the airport. And when I come to Capitol Hill, I also practice walking meditation, because each step made in mindfulness is very nourishing, very healing, and brings solidity and freedom to me. When I walk like that, I do not think. Because if you keep thinking, and then you are lost in your thinking, you do not enjoy every step you make. Walking in the kingdom of God, walking in the pure land of the Buddha, is what we can do right here and right now. With the energy of mindfulness, concentration, you can enjoy every step. And each step like that is a very very nourishing and very healing. Practicing with a friend or with a community is very easy. It sounds easy when you hear about the practice. But if you are alone practicing mindful breathing, mindful walking, it might be difficult if you don't have a brother, a sister, or a friend that is practicing with you. So it may be possible that you invite your spouse, your friend, a member of your staff to practice with you while you walk. Going home to our body, recognize the presence of our body, and help our body to relax, to release the tension. We can bring a relief right away in after a few minutes. And then after that, we can come home to the feelings and the emotions in us. Breathing in, I'm aware of my feeling. Breathing out, I calm. I release the tension in my feeling. And that kind of practice can be done at any time and anywhere. When I step into an airplane, I always make steps in mindfulness. When I sit in an airplane, I can always practice mindful breathing in order to be with myself and to take care of myself. The fact is that if we do not know how to take care of ourselves, to love ourselves, we cannot take care of the people we love. Self-love is the foundation for the love of another person. If you love someone, the greatest gift you can make to him or to her is your true presence. And if you are caught in your thinking, in your worries, in the past and the future, you are not truly present, and you don't have the most precious thing to offer to your beloved one. And that is why practicing mindful breathing or walking in order to go home to the present moment and become fully alive, fully present, you have something very precious to offer to your beloved one. Darling, I am really here for you. How can you love if you are not there? To be there is a practice. To be there, mind and body together, fully present, fully available. And that is possible with the practice of mindful breathing, mindful walking. And if you are really there, your beloved one will know it. If you pretend to be there, he will know. To bring our mind back to our body, to become fully present in the here and the now, you are in a position of taking care of your beloved one. So our own presence in the here and the now will make something else available to you. That something else is life. Your beloved one belong to life. The kingdom of God belong to life. And if you make yourself available in the here and now, the kingdom of God or your beloved one become available to you at the same time. When I drink some tea, if I drink mindfully, and that is called mindful drinking, if I establish myself in the here and the now and become fully present, and my tea become fully present also, it is possible for us to drink our tea or to eat our breakfast mindfully. And you might ask the question as you have so many to think, so many things to take care, to think about. You have to think about them. This is the practice of non-thinking.